Good afternoon, everyone. Here's Ford Mustang 98 guy. In today's in-depth review, let's take an in-depth look at this 2002 Chevrolet Cavalier. And today I'm going to give you all a full in-depth review and walk around of the Cavalier. I'm going to start it up. I'm going to show the engine. I'm also going to give you all, show you all the interior and the exterior of the car. And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start it up and let it run. Also comes with keyless entry. It's a, looks like a light silver exterior. Silver on the outside, I guess. Gray cloth interior. Car is in good condition. Interior is in good shape. The exterior would be probably in, this car's low. Put the seat back a little bit. That's better. Car's in good shape overall. $186,000. That fires right up. Two-spoke steering wheel. Gonna need some power steering fluid, I think. It's very sporty though. Let's work this off to the side. Anti-lock brakes. It's got a 4-speed automatic transmission. Low gear selection. Alright. Let's flip on the headlights. Hazards. Got a traction control light on. Manual windows, and we'll check out the exterior. This car is so low, holy God. Standard Continental tires. Oh, these are Ford hubcaps. Wonder where they come off from. It's got Ford hubcaps on it. Pretty cool. Pretty nifty. Exhaust. Third brake light up top. Here's your radio antenna. Let's pop the hood. Coming up to the engine. Just a second. You have GM's 2.2 liter SFI 4-cylinder. There's your battery. Good reliable engine. It's even good on gas too. This car is actually pretty quick as well. This car is also the twin of the Pontiac Sunfire. Alright, let's close the hood. Alright, now check out the interior. Right here you have your power door locks, manual windows right here. You have your manual windows, crank up windows. Full manual driver's seat, pretty basic, you know, pretty basic interior, manual tilting steering wheel. Nothing pretty special about this car. We got a traction control light on. Let's give her a couple revs. Sounds good. Nice. Alright. Now check out the interior. Down here, you have your, so there's water bottles there. You have your climate control right here. Get your fan speed. Your temperature right there. You have your temperature right there. And you have your different zones, including your front defrost, air conditioning, recirculation. It's all there, you know. And you have your, and down there you have a little bit of storage down there. Same with along with two cup holders. Put these back. Bit of storage down there. Your handbrake. Your cigarette lighter in there. AM FM radio with CD player. Just a second here. 680 news.
West of Jameson.
Six preset stations there. Storage in there. I think you also have a, in here, I think that's a, another cup holder, I guess. Nothing special about this car anyways, you know, it's pretty basic looking. Pretty basic. Off to this side, you have your headlights and turn signals. Wipers on this side. You have low speed. And you got high speed right there. You have your air vents right there. Cigarette lighter in there. Over here, you have your gas gauge, temperature, your speedometer, as well as your RPM gauge off to the right, your tachometer. Says a couple times a year, young not a bad car at all. Manual dimming rearview mirror. And over here, you have an interior light as well. And it works. Yeah, it's pretty much about in the interior. There's not really that much to see. So, anyways, we'll go ahead and unlock the rest of the doors. Put the window down a little bit. And check out the back seat. Yeah, nothing in the back seat. Pretty basic. Pretty basic looking car. 1,800 customers in that area. There's no word yet on the time of restoration. Stay with 680 News for the latest on this developing story. And you can even fold that seat down as well. You know, pretty basic, you know. Good old crank up windows. Pretty basic car. Let's open the trunk. I gotta pop it from here. Information to contact the London Police Service or Crime Stoppers. 6:30. My hands are a bit dirty. That's all right. You can put the seat back if you want. Folds down. And then you can put cargo stuff in the back too. Pretty nifty. Storage down there. Full manual passenger seat. Pretty basic. Oh, man, it's low. So low.
in the next few days.
680 News Time, 737. Tomorrow, Labor Day, and there are a number of shutdowns to keep in mind. Among the closures, LCBO and beer stores, banks and government offices, most grocery stores,
a box, and post offices. Pretty much about it, you know.
There will also be no mail delivery tomorrow. The TTC is running on a holiday schedule with service starting at 6.
It's 2002, what do you can expect?
Our transit is running on a weekend schedule with extra trains running on lines to get people to and from the CME. As for what's open...
Shut it down.
Each of those locations with modified hours tomorrow. All major restaurants will also be open, as well as tourist attractions, including the RAM.
Shut it down. Hope you guys enjoyed. Full in-depth review on the 2002 Cavalier. Stay tuned for my next video. We'll see you next time.